This video, we're gonna find what alpha plus minus beta is equal to based on some facts we've learned in previous videos. So, sine alpha plus beta must be equal to sine. No, tan alpha plus or minus beta must be equal to sine plus or minus beta over cos alpha plus or minus beta due to that trig identity that we learned a few videos back. If you can't remember that, then be sure to check that out. We're just going to write those things out, remembering that sine alpha plus or minus beta is equal to sine alpha cos beta plus or minus cos alpha multiplied by sine beta, and then cos alpha plus or minus beta is equal to, sorry about that, is equal to cos alpha cos beta minus or plus sine alpha sine beta. Now, from this line to the next, we're going to divide both numerator and denominator by cos alpha cos beta. And if you divide the numerator and the denominator by the same thing, the fraction's still equal to what it was before. So, dividing this first term by cos alpha cos beta, the cos betas cancel out, and we get sine alpha over cos alpha, which is tan alpha. Then we've still got the plus or minus. This time, dividing by cos alpha cos beta, the cos alphas cancel out. And then we've got sine beta over cos beta, so that's plus or minus tan beta. Cos alpha cos beta divided by cos alpha cos beta is just 1, clearly. Minus plus sine alpha over sine beta, so we get sine alpha over cos alpha multiplied by sine beta over cos beta, so that is tan alpha tan beta. Now, just to finish this video off, so that is in terms of tan, what tan alpha plus or minus beta is equal to. Now we want to work out the double angle formula for tan. Again, in terms of tan itself, so 2 alpha, so that just means we substitute in beta, well, alpha for beta, and because we're looking at plus here, we take whatever's top here, so on this top line we'll use the plus sign, on this bottom we'll use the negative sign. So that's equal to tan alpha plus tan alpha, so that's 2 tan alpha. Tan alpha multiplied by tan alpha, so that's tan squared alpha. So it's a pretty simple derivation, both of these things, but it's important to be able to do and remember the steps yourself, so it could come up in exams, and just to remember this formula for quick use. But that's it for this video, and I'll see you in the next one.